Have you ever wondered if life exists on other planets? The universe is massive, containing thousands of potential candidates. However, Earth is the only planet we know of that supports life. And we're not talking about just a handful of species. Earth is home to millions of different organisms that all interact together to create the world we live in. So, what is it about our planet that makes it so unique? And how can we make sense of how life interacts here? Today, we'll be exploring this topic as we describe the scientific field of ecology and its importance, explain the structure of the biosphere, and differentiate between the various biomes that exist within it. Let's get into it. Ecology is the study of how living things interact with each other and their environment. This field of biology is really cool because it takes a lot of what we've been learning, such as cellular processes, genetics, and biodiversity, and allows us to examine the relationship between them. By studying this field of science, we gain a deeper understanding of how all living things are connected, which, in turn, allows us to make more informed decisions about how we choose to interact with the world. To begin, let's talk about what makes our planet so special, the biosphere. This is the part of the Earth where all life exists. You're sitting in it right now. It includes the lithosphere, or land beneath our feet, the hydrosphere, or water in our oceans and lakes, and the atmosphere, which is made up of the air we breathe. The atmosphere is important not only because it provides life-giving resources like oxygen, carbon dioxide, and nitrogen, but it also protects us from the sun's radiation and helps regulate the planet's temperature. All of these functions are possible only because the combination of gases in our atmosphere is perfect for each of them. If the amount of oxygen, carbon dioxide, or nitrogen in the atmosphere was different, life here wouldn't be possible. Another reason Earth is special is because it's the perfect distance from the sun, where water can exist in liquid form. If it was significantly closer, Earth would be too hot for life, boiling the precious water away. If it was significantly farther, it would be too cold, like Mars, where water only exists as ice. However, just because conditions in general are perfect for life, doesn't mean that the biosphere is all exactly the same. Earth is constantly revolving around the sun and spinning on its axis, which is tilted, so different parts of the planet are exposed to varying amounts of sunlight. This creates variations within the biosphere called biomes, which are large areas characterized by their soil, vegetation, wildlife, and climate or weather. Studying biomes gives a larger perspective and appreciation of the diversity of life on Earth. Are you ready to explore these biomes with me? Before we start, what kind of biomes do you think exist on the planet? Write your thoughts in your guided notes. The first biome we'll be discussing is the rainforest. Rainforests exist near the equator of the Earth. And half of all life on our planet exists in this biome. The climate is perfect for life. It's warm with heavy rainfall, and the soil is rich in nutrients and organic matter, making it an ideal environment for plants to thrive. The vegetation in a rainforest is abundant, with tall trees, lush ferns, and a variety of climbing vines and shrubs. This allows for a complex network of life that includes many species, such as birds, primates, reptiles, and insects. A temperate forest is a type of forest found in areas with moderate climates, typically in regions with four distinct seasons. If you live in an area with seasons, you probably have these near you. The climate is characterized by cool to warm temperatures, with moderate rainfall throughout the year. The soil in a temperate forest is fertile and rich in nutrients, supporting a variety of vegetation. This includes deciduous trees, such as oak, maple, and birch, which shed their leaves annually, as well as evergreens like pines and firs. The dense canopy created by the trees provides a habitat for a wide range of wildlife, including deer, squirrels, birds, and insects. A desert is a harsh environment with very little rainfall and extreme temperatures. It's characterized by a climate that is dry, with temperatures varying widely depending on the type of desert. Many deserts are very hot during the day and cold at night, while some, like polar deserts, are frozen solid year-round. The soil in a desert is typically rocky and sandy, with limited nutrients and water available for plant growth. As a result, vegetation in a desert is scarce and consists primarily of drought-resistant plants such as cacti, succulents, and shrubs. Despite the harsh conditions, some species of wildlife such as snakes, lizards, and rodents have adapted to the desert environment and are able to survive in this ecosystem. A tundra is a treeless and barren landscape found near the North and South Poles. Its characteristics include a climate that is harsh with long, freezing winters and short, cool summers, with low levels of precipitation. The soil in a tundra is permanently frozen, known as permafrost, making it difficult for plants to take root and grow. Vegetation in a tundra is limited to low-growing plants such as mosses, lichens, and shrubs, as well as a few hardy flowers that bloom briefly in the summer. Despite the harsh conditions, a variety of wildlife such as birds, Arctic foxes, and caribou have adapted to the tundra and are able to survive in this unique environment. A boreal forest, also known as a taiga, is a type of forest typically found in the northern hemisphere. As far as its characteristics go, the climate is cold and snowy, with long, harsh winters and short, cool summers. The soil in a boreal forest is typically nutrient-rich and well-drained, supporting a variety of vegetation. This includes evergreen trees such as pines, spruces, and firs, and a dense undergrowth of shrubs and ferns. Despite the harsh conditions, a variety of wildlife such as moose, wolves, and birds have adapted to the boreal forest and are able to survive and thrive in this unique environment. A grassland is a vast and rolling landscape dominated by grasses and other low-growing plants. The climate is characterized by moderate temperatures and moderate to low levels of precipitation, with long, hot summers and short, cool winters. The soil in a grassland is fertile and well-drained, and the vegetation is dominated by grasses and wild flowers, with a few scattered trees. Wildlife in a grassland is diverse and includes many species of mammals, such as bison, pronghorns, and prairie dogs, as well as a variety of birds, reptiles, and insects. A savanna is similar to a grassland, but it's characterized by more scattered trees in addition to grasses and other low-growing vegetation. The climate is hot and dry, with warm temperatures and a moderate to low level of precipitation, typically in the form of seasonal rain. The soil in a savanna is often nutrient-rich, supporting a diverse array of wildlife. This includes many species of mammals, such as lions, elephants, giraffes, and zebras, as well as a variety of birds, reptiles, and insects. And with that, we have finished up our introductory lesson on ecology and the biosphere. We've learned that Earth is an incredible planet with conditions that are just right for life, and ecology is the study of how life interacts with the environment. The biosphere is the part of Earth where all life exists and can be divided into large areas called biomes, which have distinct climates, soil, vegetation, and wildlife. Scientists don't know for sure if life exists outside of Earth, but the search continues every day, with our own planet serving as a shining example of possibilities to come. In our next lesson, we'll dive deeper into the field of ecology as we explore how organisms interact to create ecosystems. Until then, I'm Anthony, and remember, life is full of wonders, so keep learning and don't ever stop wondering. Hey!